Back in 2011, we launched the Reinvent the Toilet Challenge. I want to tell you about some of the solutions our partners have come up with. The EcoSan waste treatment system by Caltech uses energy from solar panels to extract clean water from human waste. This water is reused for toilet flushing. The University of South Florida's new generator is a treatment system designed to work with any conventional toilet. It runs on solar power. Water gets treated with a nanomembrane filter, and there's no septic tank that fills up. The solids are digested by anaerobic bacteria on one side of the membrane. Clean water flows through the other side. Cranfield University has designed what looks like a typical toilet, but it uses an odor barrier and an automated scraper so you can flush it without any water. A screw separates the wastewater from feces. Clean water is filtered out for reuse. Solids are burned within the unit, and heat from the burning is used to help dry the next batch of solids. It's a very clever toilet. Duke University's neighborhood treatment system is designed for a community of about 1,200 people. It mixes fecal sludge and oxygen under high pressure and heat, which breaks down the harmful pathogens and creates water, nitrogen, and ash. Helbling's HT Clean toilet processes the flush water, urine, and feces together using combined pressure and heat like a pressure cooker, resulting in a mixture of safe solids and water. The water is filtered for reuse for flushing. The Janicki Firelight toilet is designed to dry human waste into thin flakes, making it easy to burn. The heat from this burning then dries out more waste. The evaporated water is captured, cleaned, and recycled for flushing. It's a self-powering toilet designed for the home. I'm optimistic that toilets like these are going to play a major role in helping us improve sanitation around the world.